I don't know if you're like me, but if you love adding campgrounds to your favorites list of places that you would love to go to someday, well, I got you covered with a handful of places that you're gonna wanna add to that list with our West Coast Beach Camping Today. How's it going? I'm Jared Gillis. Welcome to the Campendium YouTube channel, where it's our hope and our goal to provide you with the information to get out there and camp. And today we're going to be covering the West Coast side of the United States, where you can camp near, at, or on the beach. Some amazing places. So with that, I want to remind you that we have a great article on the Campendium webpage where you can go and read all the tips and ways to be safe as you camp near the beach. Just a reminder, because some of those things can be a little bit dangerous depending on the situation. You want to be aware of weather. You want to be aware of tides and driving on the beach. You don't want to get stuck. So we have all those tips in a great article online. So let's dive into this list now. We're gonna begin our list in Southern California and work our way up to Washington. So the first one on our list is Crystal Cove State Park. Bill said, "What a beautiful view of the ocean from high up on the bluff over the sea. The beach is amazing. I think it's over 2 miles long with tidal pools to explore." Next on the list is Rincon Parkway Campground. Camper says, "This was totally my style of RVing. Nobody on either side, falling asleep to ocean waves, walking out the door and down the rocks to the beach. Just perfect." Van Tramp was a little skeptical at first, but said, "Under the awning with a cocktail and my sweetheart and evening sunsets could hardly get any better." That brings us to Kirk Creek Campground. That's a lot of C's, K's. The Kirk Creek Campground, say that 10 times fast, I dare you. One review says, "I have wanted to camp here ever since traveling out west for the first time 8 years ago. We finally made it happen and wish we could have stayed indefinitely." That's pretty easy to see after seeing those amazing pictures. But let's move along to Half Moon Bay State Beach. Reading through the reviews, they said that there was a back-end spot that gave them a panoramic view of Half Moon Bay. The pounding surf and the changing weather, it was a perfect setting. Moving up the coast to Wright's Beach Campground. With the way this campground is laid out, you can see why Fables and Trails says, "This is likely our favorite beach camping spot so far along the coast, as you are literally backed into the beach." With so many amazing places to camp along the coast in California, that was really just some highlights. But let's move into Oregon at Harris Beach State Park. David says, "The location of this park is phenomenal. A super short walk to a fantastic beach full of sea stacks, tide pools, and sandy beaches is just breathtaking." Tiger Nomad said, "Harris Beach State Park is a beloved camp spot on the Oregon coast, and it lives up to that reputation." But let's move along to Cape Blanco State Park, and let's just look at some of the highlights of what people are saying in the reviews. "A fantastic Oregon State Park. One of my favorite parks. Beautiful coastline with the campground set in trees. One of our favorites on the coast, secluded. Off-season coastal treat." Next is Bullards Beach State Park. A couple of the reviews say, "Of all the Oregon state parks, this is the one I love the most. I spent almost 3 weeks and 2 visits here simply because the beaches here are amazingly beautiful to photograph and to walk on." Another one says, "When I bought my first travel trailer, I vowed never to go to an RV park. That was before I went to Bullards Beach Campground. It is one of the best I've ever been at. Room for kids to play and private sites." That brings us to next on our list, which is Fort Stevens State Park. One of the reviews says, "Love this park, and there is probably close to 100 geocaches. The kayaking looks spot on too, with a shipwreck to explore on the beach." Moving up the coast now to Washington, they kind of set the bar a little low with the first name on this one, but let me tell you, it's a good one, with Cape Disappointment State Park. Ranger Cadwell said, "State park of epic proportions. My wife and I were on a tour of National Park Service sites and stayed here on our trip. This campground, I didn't know what to expect, but it did not disappoint in the slightest. It was quiet, well kept, and close to the beach." I'm sure there's some history behind that name, but good job trying to keep the people out with Cape Disappointment. Let's move up the coast to South Beach Campground. This is in Olympic National Park, and there's really nothing to see here unless you like a $15 campground or $7.50 for the senior discount with some beautiful views and a good time. I mean, seriously, people are labeling their pictures just another sunset. Let's move along to Point Hudson RV Park. RV Nomad said, waterfront RV park with awesome views and walking distance to a seriously charming town. We had only planned on staying for two nights, but you just can't walk away from that view. We've got a few more here with Whiskey Creek Beach. One review says, we are not usually big on private campgrounds, but Whiskey Creek Beach is an exception to the rule. Between the tide pools and the views, look at these. I don't think you can take a bad photo. This is every photo that everybody takes, and they're all great. Let's move along to Fort Flagler State Park. Van Gogh says, one of the gems of the Washington State Park system. Stunning scenery, gorgeous forest trails, eagles, lots of deer, and old military bunkers to explore. And last on our list is Camano Island State Park. This here's what looks like to be a beautiful park that the locals enjoy. It has beautiful views and so much potential to hike around or explore in a kayak on the water. Well, that's gonna do it for today. So if you liked these locations or if you liked this video, give us a thumbs up. If you haven't already, hit that subscribe button. And remember to keep exploring and to travel safe. We'll see you next time.